Today is the NHL trade deadline, and yet it seems like GMs around the league just couldn't wait to make a bunch of trades. So despite the fact that I am still expecting a good amount of action to come about later today, here's a quick video to talk about all the most important trades from this week so far, and probably butcher some names along the way. This video is going to be in two parts, one for each conference. This video is going to cover all of the action from the West. Let's kick things off with my home team here in Edmonton. The Oilers started off the week with a three-way trade involving the Ducks and the Lightning. The Oilers acquire Adam Henrique, Sam Carrick, an unsigned goalie Ty Taylor, and a 2024 7th in the deal. In exchange, they gave the Ducks a 2024 1st and a conditional 2025 5th, and Tampa got a 2026 4th. The Ducks are retaining 50% of Henrique's contract, and the Lightning are holding another 25%. I think this trade is great for the Oilers. It goes a long way to helping them accomplish their goal of being a much deeper team going into the postseason this year. That being said, they weren't done there because they also acquired defenseman Troy Stetcher and a 2024 7th from the Coyotes in exchange for a 2027 4th. Stetcher is a right-shooting defenseman who I expect will slot into Edmonton's third defensive line. If I had to take a guess, Cody Ceci will probably slide out of the lineup to make room for him. Our divisional rival Vegas was also plenty busy. They started by trading away a 2024 2nd and a 2026 4th to Washington in exchange for Anthony Mantha. Mantha has 34 points on the season over the course of 57 games, so he'll be a nice addition for the Golden Knights. Then they put Mark Stone's LTIR cap to good use as they picked up Noah Hanifin in a three-way deal involving the Flames and the Flyers. The Flames get a 2025 1st, Daniil Miromanov, and a conditional 2025 3rd in the deal, while the Flyers take home a 2024 5th. This is a great pickup for Vegas. Hanifin is going to add a lot to their defense and make them just that much harder to play against. Bringing it over to the Central Division, the Nashville Predators kept it relatively simple. They acquired Anthony Beauvillier from the Chicago Blackhawks in exchange for a 2024 5th round pick. Beauvillier brings 14 points in 45 games between the Canucks and the Blackhawks this season, so he should help bring some depth to Nashville's lineup. Considering they're practically guaranteed to end up in the playoffs at this point, I expect to see more action from the Predators today, so stay tuned for that. By contrast, that brings us to arguably the busiest team this week, the Colorado Avalanche. Firstly, they acquire Sean Walker and a 2026 5th from the Flyers in exchange for Ryan Johansson and a conditional 2025 1st. Then they exchanged Bowen Byram one for one for Casey Mittelstadt from the Sabres. I actually think that trade really benefits both teams. It makes the contending Colorado better now, but the aspiring Buffalo better down the line. Nice stuff for both of them. After that though, the Avs went out and got Brandon Duhaime from the Minnesota Wild in exchange for a 2026 3rd. And to finish it all off, they got Yakov Trenin from the Predators, as well as the unsigned defenseman Graham Sword in exchange for Jeremy Hansel, I don't know, I said that the same three times, and a 2025 3rd going the other way. Not gonna lie, the Avs have had a question mark for me this year. MacKinnon is obviously on a tear, but it kind of feels like the rest of the team fell behind. But these moves elevate them back to being a real danger in my mind, so it'll be interesting to see how they fare in the postseason this year. And that's all of the action out of the West. A reminder that this is actually a two-part video, with the other half covering all of the moves from the East. So if you like this video, please go check that one out, and let me know down below who you think improved the most out of the Western Conference. For more hockey trade news, stay tuned.